Hey, what's going on, Knuckles family? What's good, Knuckles fiends out there? What's going on, Knuckles family? I said it already. I don't even know. But welcome back to the challenge, Double Agents episode recap. And wait, episode recap. And now we're on to episode 12. Yeah, episode 12. Just to make sure, episode 12. Like I said, it honestly feels like I always say this, but it honestly feels like yesterday the season just started. And now, like I said, we're getting closer to the end. So, I mean, I might have to relook at the season because there are some things I like and some things I didn't like. But we'll get to that in when the season's over, pretty much. But today's episode, we know, leaving right where the last episode ended off, where, you know, I didn't like how, you know, they, at the end of episode 10, they said, oh, security breach. All right, cool. What's the security breach? On episode 11, the end is, oh, security breach. We should have to wait another week for to know what was going on. So TJ basically said, you know, nothing is what it seems now. Richie, a buddy of mine, was saying that maybe it was security breach because CT told Devin. At first it seemed like, yeah, but then again, I mean, like, they have heard, then another buddy of mine that I work with, she said, you know, yeah, but they have a right to do what they want to do with the book. So, like, I don't see why how that can be a security breach. So, I mean, both sides made sense, but pretty much it was the moment that we've been waiting for, but we expected to happen sooner or later. A double elimination finally, like, happened. Like, towards the end, until I said episode 12? Normally they have double eliminations maybe beginning of the season. So I was a little bit surprised it happened so late. I was expecting that, but I'm like, god dang, man, it's pretty late for this one. So, you know, this kind of works out in Devin and CT's favor. So now like I said, Miona, Gabby, and Devin were down there. But now CT's like, okay, who got the second, who was the closest to those? Like, pretty much, you know, Devin was the first amount of first. Who was the second amount of first? It was Josh and Nani. And Josh was blindsided. He didn't see it come through. You know that. He ain't ready to go in. So now, CT has some power now. Now, Devin has a moment. CT can choose who he wants. But as to respect for Devin and Centered Alliance, he said to Devin, who do you want? So Devin said Devin picked Darrell, mainly because, you know, well, he said he wants to go to Darrell because, you know, he sent him in there. But technically it was CT that really picked him in there. So then CT had a choice of who he wants to go up against. So he's like, I'm gonna go up against Josh. So the first round, and it was a guy's elimination, no surprise. So first round was Devin and Darrell, and it was for Dead Ringer. It was the same elimination that Ashley and Cam did, but they made it a little bit farther, they made it a little bit more tougher, and also you have to finish your puzzle at the end. So, oh my god, like, you know, I'll say this, I was going to be happy whoever won this challenge. I think I was leading more towards the road than I did, like, the OGs, but I would have Devin, you know, because honestly, if Devin were to win this, he would, oh my god, I would have been, oh, he would have had such bragging rights. It honestly would have been good TV. It honestly probably would have been good TV. Like, it probably would have. Man, the Devin's looking at his face was like, yeah, I'm ready to do this challenge. Like, because, you know, he's a puzzle guy. So for Darrell, you know, for him, he has to hurry up and fit it, get all his pieces out, down first. Because if you let Devin ahead of you with that puzzle, it's not looking so good. So these guys were not so bad. They were, like, you know, pretty even at the start of it. But the only problem was, when it got to the puzzle, Devin's brain just, like, went off. Like, it's one of those ones where, like, yo, just went blank. Like, no, like, you know, I don't know what's going on right now. So I'm looking at that. I'm like, yo, man, this ain't looking good for Devin. Like, you know, eventually, Darrell White wins that round. And so he gets his gold score. I'm happy for Darrell. Now, I'll say this. Darrell technically is the only one that's been playing this game, you know, non-sneaky. Now, I don't know if he's ever done any sneaky stuff before, but, like, Darrell's, like, you know, he's been flying under the radar and stuff like that. He's never once get into all like beef and shit like that. So I respect where he's coming from, but you know, sadly Devin goes home. But I'm happy that Darrell got his gold skull now. I mean, it's been a long time coming. You know, I would really like for if Darrell really wins this, man, that would be a good combo. Now I want to call it a comeback because he made it close on Invasion of Champions. 30-30, he was the first. One of the first people to get sent home. So, you know, I think it will be, you know, a bit of a comeback if Darrell will win this. So now we get to CT and Josh, and CT destroyed him. Like, destroyed him. And what I mean by destroyed him, like, when CT got all his puzzles first, Josh was still trying to get all his pieces. CT figured out that puzzle in a matter of seconds. The fastest one out there. And people know CT is great at puzzles, so you give him a puzzle, he's very good at finishing. And he's also said, you know, he played that with his son, so you know, he already knew what he was doing. So it was a done deal for Josh. And you know, bye Josh. So he's gonna come back and be a challenge champion. Yeah, that's not gonna happen. So I mean, hey, believe in yourself, that's fine, but it ain't gonna happen. Like that's not. Yeah, that's not gonna happen, Josh. I'm sorry. Reality sets it, and that's not gonna happen. So, yeah. Now, CT has a choice: you either stay with Big T, or you pick a new partner. And CT did the right thing. He chose Ken to be his partner. Now, the way how he did it, by saying, I won't kill Kim! I won't kill Kim! I learned my lesson. Like, he made a scene about it. As a big slap in the face to Big T. Now, if you want to say, okay, if you want to say, it was such a dick move for CT to do that, well, don't blame, excuse me, don't blame him. Blame the people that made the game. Those are the rules. You could do that. They gave him the option to do that. So, as far as I know, no one owes anybody anything. Now, granted, this is probably the best show that I've seen Big T do. The other one they were hanging on, which honestly it wasn't all that much. Like, okay, like, but like, let's be real, like, Big T or Cam, that's not a hard decision to do. Like I said, the way how CT did it, I don't like how he did it, but like, let's be real, Big T or Cam. If you gotta think about that, like, like, come on, man. People say, oh, like, oh, boy, that's his partner. He did it wrong. It's like I said, you can switch partners. So, like, was Kyle a dick when he got Cam? Was, who else? There was other people that, was Fessy a dick when he chose Casey to be his partner? Because you knew he picked somebody better? But that's part of the game, man. Like... And not only that, I mean, maybe it's a poor comparison, but like, Big T, as far as I'm concerned, you didn't want Joe as your partner. So, I mean, great, he got eliminated, so he had another choice, but it's like, come on, man. Like I said, the way how CT did it, I didn't like. Why did CT did it? He didn't like. Now, Kyle was mad, obviously. I mean, because that's he took pick one of the best girls. Now Kyle's like, I can't trust CT. He's like, yeah, this, I mean, no one can trust you either. And Darrell, you know, he's stuck with Amber B. Then Corey was teamed up with Gabby, and I was teamed up with Big T. So yeah, at the house, Kyle was messing. Well, you can't be trusted. You can't be trusted. It's like. You know, CT's gonna brought us some facts. It's like, bro, you lied to me. You lied to my friend. Like, you're the biggest snakes in every season. Everyone knows that Kyle is a snake. He's just mad that someone did it first before him. Like, let's try to say, like, everyone's a bunch of hypocrites on this show. Mainly more Kyle, because, like, Kyle, you're known for sneakiness and shit like that, bro. Like, come on. Like, come on. And yeah, does this hurt Big T's feelings? Yeah, it does, but it's like, I'm telling y'all, like, that's the game, man. Like, that's the game. Like, I'm gonna choose somebody better. I am. Wait. First of all, yeah. My friend just texted me. Who I always text about, yo, you watch the challenge? You watch the challenge every episode. But yeah, man, like, pretty much the majority of his episode was, you know, like, the first part was the elimination. Then most of the next part was, you know, Big T, you know, everyone getting mad at CT. And it's like, how does that make it public enemy number one? Like Cam's, oh, now he's a, now CT's public enemy number one for choosing partners? Like, y'all overreacted this stuff, man. Like, he's trying to win. Like I said, how he did it by calling Cam, I get that. But, like, come on, man. Like, it's been, like, if Big T, maybe it would have been better if, you know, Big T, I think CT was going to choose partners regardless anyway. Especially after we, you know, the whole tough times, that tug of war challenge, not tug of war, but that whole wrestling match between Big T and Cam. Yeah, that was not gonna happen. That was, yeah, we all know who the winner is with that. So I just think everyone's like, you know, making a CT publicly number one for that. It's just ridiculous to me. And you know, then you have Corey, you know, trying to, you know, cheer and see they had pretty much, they had a night off, they had a day off. And, you know, Big T is trying to Kyle was saying that in after CT and Darrell was like, why is everybody cheering? Why is everybody clapping? These are their challenge guys. They have a straight to the, they have a ticket to the final. Yeah, we're screwed right now, but you know, yeah, I mean, technically they kinda are, so yeah. But no. So they had their day, you know, off and stuff like that. You know, it's like Corey's trying to, you know, cheer up Big T. He's like, bro, Corey, you already said it. Amber down there because you know you don't want to be partners with her, so it's like it's just annoying. It really is. Like, this is a game, folks. It sucks, it's dirty, but like I said, she could have handled it better. I would have done it in a heartbeat. Big T over Cam over Big T, yeah. I'm not even gonna hesitate with that. So now later that night, Nam was having back issues. So his back was hurting him, so he had to get checked out. So we kinda assume that he's probably gonna be gone. Probably assume at that point. But Big T and CT were talking. So Big T said, I'm not the strongest person in this house. I already know that. But the way how you picked over me was, yeah, you know, y'all was my supporter, but you kept, you were my supporter. Everyone that could be, you were there for me. So she pretty much meant that, yeah, you know, I trash. I understand Cam Strowman is better than me. Then, you know, CT kind of like, when he said to her, when CT said to her, you're not ready to run out. You're not ready for that final. Yeah, it's true, but when keeping it real goes wrong, now she just calls him a liar, which is like, it's now he said he broke a promise. You want to call him a liar for that? I don't know, maybe, but he broke a promise, you know. But he's, I don't think he's a liar though, and, you know. But the thing I didn't like, how it's like, imagine me, I gotta tell my son that we didn't win $1 million. I don't think he had to bring his son into that. So, I'm sorry, guys. I don't think it needed to happen. Hold on. I didn't want to get that on camera. But yeah, He didn't bring up his son up, but you know, the argument, it just didn't go so well. Like I said, the way how he did it was wrong, but I mean, he made a game move, man. He made a game move, and like, as much as I like CT, yeah, I mean, that's, yeah, Big T, she's not on a level with these, somebody, she's not on a level of Cam, she's not on a level of Vanessa, she's not on the level of Casey. Like, we know that's not, it's, it, I, he, I mean, he told the truth. And it's, yeah, he told the truth. I mean, that's the game, you know. Does it suck for this Big T? Absolutely, it does. But it's like, you know, she had to have known that this was gonna be coming. She had to have known. Like she had to have known, honestly. And then even to say that, you know, she knows I'm not the best girl here. It's like that for him to say you're not ready for that final, it's like what triggered? Because you just admitted that you said you're not the best girl there. So like you're not the best girl there, and yeah, you probably aren't ready for that final though. You know what I'm saying? So that wouldn't make any sense. But, you know, like I said, that thing didn't go so well. Now yeah, like I said, majority of these episodes, you know, like the whole Big T and CT type of thing. Now, it was funny. Everyone seemed okay. We have a night off, no challenge. Challenge alarm activated. And it was a night challenge. Now, unfortunately, Nam can't participate because of his back issue. She had to get sent home. Now, which means Big T can't compete. Now, she can't compete for a gold school. And now, I think there's only one more gold school for the girls. And it's running out, man. Time is running out. But before the challenge even started, it's called Survive the Night. And they gotta go through a set of torture stuff for them to win this challenge. And it's at night, they're in a prison cell, like they're in a prison cell cage, yada yada. And it looks pretty, I don't know what's gonna happen, man, because the episode does end with, you know, the challenge getting ready to start. So we'll have to see what happens, man. Definitely looks intimidating. It definitely does. But I will say for the guys, though, I think Corjo, one that doesn't have a gold score right now, I believe. Because now Nam went home, so like he's definitely running out of time right now. So and he's got to go up against some heavy hitters like Fessy, Kyle, Leroy, Darrell, CT. Choose your poison. And for the girls, there's one more gold skull, so Nam needs to get together because she was crying that was her supporter and stuff like that. That was her emotional system. I mean, yeah, it sucks, but honestly, you have a better player in Kyle, so. It sucks your friend's gone, but Kyle's definitely 10 times better than Josh. I'll take that every day of the week right there. Take that every day of the week. But, you know, it's her. Actually, yeah, the only girls are Cam that have one, Anissa, Casey, and Amber. So who's Nani or Gabby Big T going to pick? I tell you one thing. They're not picking Casey. They're not picking Cam. They're going to be between, like, Amber or Anissa. So, yeah, I gotta say, man, episode started great. The whole CT and Big T, I mean, maybe it went on for too long. I mean, I guess that day off thing where we're at that hot tub or whatever, the warm water was nice enough, but like, it wasn't really like, oh my God, we went in this episode. So, it was like whatever episode, but yeah, I mean, I'm sure CT and Big T are already made up by now, but right now it's like, yeah, for whatever reason, CT's proclaiming everyone because, you know, he chose partners. Oh, he can't be trusted. People have the option to choose partners, people. That's part of the game. But like I said, I guess we forgot about what Fessy did, especially with the way he did to Nelson. Let's not forget about that. Kai, one of the sneakiest people in the game. So let's not forget about that. But you know, CT does something for his game. Also, he's public enemy number one. I don't know. Make it make sense, people. Make it make sense. But hope you guys enjoyed this recap. I'm getting tired, so that's why I'm like hurry up finishing this up right now. If any of my friends are watching this, man, if y'all still want to join me for this, man, like I'm open to it. Maybe we'll have to do it on that day of the night of the challenge. But like maybe like a day or 2 days after you talk about the latest episode. So maybe that'll be fun. So. I'm gonna quickly wrap this up. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. Give me a like, share of this video. We're getting towards the end, man. We're getting towards the end. Like, I guess only a few episodes before we get to the final. Yeah, like, see, how many guys are left? So it's Corey, Darrell, CT, Fessy, Kyle, and Leroy. I don't know if the final's gonna be for three guys or three girls. We'll have to see. We'll get to the end of that, man. I can't wait. I'm excited. So, everybody, y'all have a good one. Like I said, I'll be the same in the comments, so don't get any spoilers. But like I said, thumbs up. subscribe, be part of this family, and give this video a share too. Share about how tired I am right now. So, everybody, y'all have a good night and be safe. See you guys next time.